Hey everyone, Daniel here from TwinBytes with another quick tutorial for you. This time I'm showing you how to import a CSV file that may be in a text format. In a previous video I showed you how to export a calendar from Outlook into a CSV format, and it puts it as a CSV type file, which really allows you to just simply double click on it and it opens Excel directly and puts the data in here. So you can see the data is in here, but it just needs a little bit of formatting so that you can read the content. But what if you exported a CSV format from some program and it puts it as a text file? If you click on it, it just opens up your notepad and it shows the data, but it's all comma delimited, which is what the CSV stands for, is comma separated values. So we're seeing everything here, but there's all these commas, so we're not able to really read this properly. So we want to take this CSV text file and import that into Excel. And I'm going to show you how to do that in this video. So the first thing you want to do is open up Excel like I have here and go up to your file menu. And you can go to open and browse. You browse to the folder where you have the file, and you may not see it in here because it's defaulting to the file types of all Excel. So you want to click in there and say show me all file types, and now we can see everything that's in this folder. So I can select the text file and open that. And this is where we get into the import wizard. So you have quite a few options here. Fixed width is if you know that they're separated by a certain number of characters, but we're not having that in this case. It is delimited, and you'd have to see how is it delimited, by commas or tabs or something else. So we know that it's comma separated, so we're choosing that. And here we have the option of choosing if your data has headers. So it recognizes from here that there is a header. So if we click that on, then it will be able to figure that part out. We'll hit next. And this is where we're choosing the delimiters. We do not use tab in this case here. We're using commas. And you can actually see what happens below in the data preview. When it was on tab, it's not looking like anything readable. But if I uncheck that and say comma delimited, now we can see our columns and things are starting to appear a little bit more normal here. And you can also have text qualifiers. So if there's text using quotes, you might want to put that in there if it's a double quote or a single quote, or maybe we don't have anything for text qualifiers. But you can see what happens here when you're doing the text qualifiers. So we're going to leave that by default, and you can experiment with this and see how it works for you. But usually the default for the text qualifier is fine. We'll hit next. And then you get to choose the data format. So general may be fine. You might have to put it as text, but this applies to each individual column. So you would select each one and you can choose if it's a text format or a date format. And you can see here that these are actually a date and these are times. So you could select the specific type of format for that, or you can just keep it as general for all of these, and it usually will import just fine. So we'll go and hit finish, and then we have it all imported, but it's a little bit squished, so you're still going to want to do something with that. So clicking up here in the top left between column A and row 1 will highlight the whole thing. Double click on the line between column A and B, and that lines up and spaces everything out properly for us. And it looks like most of the stuff is in here correctly. I can see the four different tests, but there's another line here that something must have gone wrong, because this should be part of the rest of this line, possibly. And it looks like that's correct here, because we're missing the information up here, which is what we have on these ones. So I got the location, priority, private, and over here you can see location. I can just cut that, move that over here, and paste it, and you can see how that lines up perfectly. So that's exactly where this was meant to be, but there's something messed up with that, because you can see that there's a comma there and a double quote at the end. So this may have wanted a text qualifier with the quotes specified, or maybe we don't specify it. So we've only got four entries in this particular example, so it was very quick and easy to fix. However, if you've got a much larger document and you have a lot of errors, you might want to re-export that, trying some different settings for the text qualifiers. But in any event, with any kind of database, and I've done many in the past, you would still need to kind of run through all this, scrolling through and eyeballing it and making some manual changes, such as what I just did over here. So that's it for this tutorial. I hope you did find it helpful, and if you did, give it a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already, and we will see you guys in the next video. All right, thanks so much. Bye for now.